Welcome to Dental and Ayurveda, a channel for basic dental and Ayurvedic sciences. Our today's chapter is Chemotherapy of Tuberculosis of Pharmacology.
Hello everyone. So here I'm going to start with pharmacology, and the topic that we are going to take is Chemotherapy of Tuberculosis. Under this topic, we can see that tuberculosis is a chronic disease and it is caused by mycobacterium tuberculosis. Now here you can see some of the problems in the treatment of tuberculosis. Like drug toxicity is the major problem that patient complains. And if a single drug is given, these drug resistant strains, they are going to emerge rapidly. And so 2, 3, or 4 drugs, they are used in combination. Then proper combination of drugs is selected to treat tubercular meningitis, because all the drugs, they don't cross the blood-brain barrier. Now difficult to treat high-risk groups. It is very difficult to treat the people who are HIV infected. Then primary drug or the mainline drug that we are going to talk about here is streptomycin. Okay, so major problems to treat tuberculosis by streptomycin are, first is parenteral administration, then toxicity is always the problem. Then you can see that this drug is not active in acidic medium. Then rifampicin. So the source of this drug is semi-synthetic derivative of Streptomyces mediterranei. Then mechanism of action, if I talk about, that this is going to act by inhibiting the DNA-dependent RNA synthesis in bacteria. So here are a few advantages of this drug. That is, first is it is bactericidal. Then it is going to kill the intracellular organisms. Then effective on intracellular and extracellular bacilli. Effective in acidic medium as well. So these are a few advantages. Then bacterial resistance develops rapidly if used alone. Like if this drug is used alone, then bacterial resistance develops rapidly. It is due to mutation of DNA-dependent RNA polymerase and alteration in the envelope of bacteria. When there is some alteration in the envelope of bacteria. Here you can see pharmacokinetics. So for various drugs, we study about their pharmacokinetics, adverse effects, and much more. So here is pharmacokinetics. So under this, you can see rapidly absorbed. This drug is rapidly absorbed from gut on oral administration. And this is also eliminated in bile. Mainly this is excreted in feces and partly in urine. So widely distributed in tissue and fluids, including CSF. Here are a few adverse effects. Under adverse effects, you can see that these are almost very common adverse effects. And you can see in most of the drugs, these nausea, vomiting, diarrhea, mental confusion, fever, chills, like this. Okay. So this is like in this particular drug, you can see that it imparts a harmless orange color in urine, sweat, tears, and sputum. And rarely, the adverse effect that is quite rare is jaundice and thrombocytopenia. Then you can see this is contraindicated in hepatic dysfunction. So this is the contraindication for this drug. Then if I talk about drug interaction, it is going to induce microsomal enzymes. So it will reduce the activity of oral contraceptives, oral antidiabetics, warfarin, phenytoin, etc. So antibacterial spectrum, if I talk about. Now under this, it is effective against this. Particular medicine is effective against gram-positive and gram-negative cocci, gram-negative bacilli, mycobacterium tuberculosis, mycobacterium lepra, and chlamydia as well. And for pox viruses also, this is effective. then you can see the uses. Some of the uses of this particular drug is definitely we are studying tuberculosis. So in combination with other drugs, you can use this medicine for tuberculosis. Then for leprosy, meningococcal carriers, hemophilus, influenza, prophylaxis, also we use this. You can see the dosage somewhere. And systemic fungal infections also. So to enhance the effect of this medicine, for systemic fungal infections, we enhance the effect of amphotericin B. We are going to use that. This particular drug we use for systemic fungal infections so that the medicine amphotericin B that we used to take in fungal infections, this is going to enhance the effect of this medicine. Then you can see isoniazid. So under this drug, it has a structural resemblance with pyridoxin and nicotinic acid. Then it is definitely going to act by interfering with the synthesis of mycobacterial cell wall. So here are a few important features of this particular drug, that it is definitely bactericidal. And then it is effective in acid and alkali medium also. Then in it is going to inhibit the atypical mycobacterium also. So about pharmacokinetics, if I talk about, this is readily absorbed from gut, well distributed in body fluids and tissues, and it is excreted in urine, partly in free form and partly in the form of metabolites. Then it is metabolized in liver by acetylation. So here we are going to talk about some adverse effects of this particular medicine. Neurotoxicity, and hepatotoxicity as well. Now in allergic reactions also, and peripheral neuritis. Here are few precautions for this drug, that it is used carefully in presence of liver and kidney disease. Liver and kidney disease, epilepsy, alcoholism, and breastfeeding mothers. So in such cases, you have to take some precautions. Then we are going to talk about ethambutol. So in this, the source of this particular drug is synthetic tuberculostatic drug. So bacterial resistance develops rapidly if used alone. So always used in combination with other anti-tubercular drugs. So definitely this is used in combination with the other drugs. Then we talk about pharmacokinetics. Now in 75% to 80% drug, it is absorbed from gut. So this is widely distributed in tissue fluids also. Then it is excreted in urine and it is partly metabolized as well. Here you can see some of the adverse effects of this. The adverse effects, it can be retinal damage or it can be optic neuritis. Then it is increased blood urate concentration and other adverse effects like giddiness, this mental disturbances, some allergies, all this can occur. And precautions is like just you have to avoid it in very young children and elderly patients. So here I'm going to talk about the other drug that we use in tuberculosis, which is, so here we are going to talk about the source of this particular drug. So it is synthetic derivative of nicotinic acid. And here are the important features of this particular drug, that it is like others, it is also bactericidal. And now particularly it is useful in tubercular meningitis. And pharmacokinetics of this drug is, it is well absorbed from gut and it is also distributed widely in tissues, including the macrophages and the cerebrospinal fluid as well. So about the adverse effects, if I talk about, it is hepatotoxicity, nausea and vomiting, some of the common adverse effects. And here you can see that bacterial resistance, so it occur rapidly if it is used alone. So these drugs, you know, mostly if they're used alone, then its bacterial resistance is more.
Our ready-to-read notes are available on our Instagram page.